Hi, it's Mike from Adaptify. There's been a few comments out there around why not use a Bungee instead of the LapStacker. We tried the Bungee and there's a number of reasons why it's nowhere near as good as a LapStacker. Just wanted to show you some of those reasons today. Okay, so I've got a variety of bungee cords here of different lengths. And straight away, that's part of the issue. The LapStacker will retract in different lengths and lock in different positions. For a bungee, it's a fixed length, so straight away there's a few issues with that. So I'll take some of these boxes of catheters, which I often take from the cupboard, and you know, as you'll see, they are quite unstable. So with the LapStacker, there they are, nice and straightforward. Nice and secure. Now, a bungee. Now, what length do I need? Okay, I'll try this one. Straight away, the ends of the bungees, unless you've got a super small frame chair, it won't fit around the tubing. So there's a couple of ways around this. I suppose you can try and bend those hooks open, and in this case I can't. I'd need to get some pliers. Or you could double it up on itself like that. And then clearly what you need to do is... That bungee is going to be too small, so that's no good. Okay, so straight away, that bungee's no good. Okay, sweet, so this is a longer bungee. So we'll do that whole process again. We'll wrap that round on itself and hope it doesn't ping off. Right, there we go. Okay. Now, how do I hook that around there? Oh, I could hook that around my brake thing there. Okay, so that wasn't any good. Ah, damn bungees. Okay, well, that didn't work. How about I try the bag here? Suitcase, there's the LapStacker, awesome. And a bungee, right, we'll try this long one again. And I don't know where I'd store this bungee, that's the other thing. I guess you might wrap it up and where do you put it? So that's a big issue. In my case, I might put it in my bag I've got underneath. Which is fantastic. So I've got it under the bag, and then I get the bag and, oh, okay, hang on, I've got to get the bungee from under there. So I've got to get that first. All right, so I get that first. Then I put the bag on. And then I've discovered I can put it around my brake. Oh, kind of. Okay. Bungee's around the brake. Oh, okay. I don't think this one's going to be quite long enough. I mean, sorry, it's too long, this bungee. So I guess one way around it would be to tie a knot in the bungee. Okay, I think that's going to work. Oh, it's not quite... It's too short now. Okay, and it's come off. Seriously, guys, bungees suck. The flat bungees, I mean, they're more or less the same. Same issues with trying to attach it and store it. Slightly more surface area, but as you can see, they're still quite narrow. And they really just won't have the same holding power as the LapStacker. Done. Laptop, no problem. Done. Different lengths, self-locking, easy to put together, easy to use with your fingers if you're quadriplegic or you have reduced hand function of some sort. Whereas, how is someone with reduced hand function going to attach a bungee on to their chair? I mean, I'm not saying it's impossible, but certainly a lot more difficult. Nowhere near as practical and simple as the LapStacker. I'll try a flat bungee and see if that makes any difference to securing these boxes. As I said, these are fixed. They won't bend to suit, so I've just kind of got to try and wrap it around. Now, one other idea, I suppose, is you could get a cable tie, and you could put a cable tie around the tubing of your chair, and then you'd have an easier way to hook your bungee on. But what I think will happen is that cable tie will get in your way, and it still may slide forward and back and interfere with your brakes. So anyway, for now, we'll just try and secure that and hope it doesn't ping off. Okay, that's still secure. All right. Now, this is going to be tricky. Whoa! Okay. I'm just really struggling to get these big ones on. I'm going to try and hook them around my brake again. Okay, it's kind of there. Now, okay. Well, there's a bit of a struggle. Now, these hooks are really, really close to my tire. Very, very difficult to get on. I don't know how long that took me to do that, but these seem to be on reasonably good, and definitely the flatter bungee helps. Whoop. So flat bungee, definitely a lot better in terms of keeping things secure. But this is just for this length, so for anything smaller, you would need a different bungee. So in essence, you want to use bungee cords. I recommend using a flat bungee, and preferably with an end that you can make size to suit your tubing. But you're really going to need a variety of different lengths for different items you carry. And they're certainly difficult to put on, especially if you've got poor hand function, and they take a lot longer. And you've got to store them. Where do you store them? You more or less got to get the bungees out before you put the item on your lap. And then again, once you've undone the bungee, you've got to store it again and put it away. How much time will that take you? A lot longer than the LapStacker, which is there by your side whenever you need it. Okay, so for those of you that still use paper, I do. I just want to carry a piece of paper across the office or through into the next room. The LapStacker comes in really handy. And the beauty of the LapStacker is it's not going to damage the paper. It's nice wide strap and even pressure all the way through, whereas a bungee will damage the edges of the paper. And maybe you want to carry a couple of boxes as well on top of the paper. Maybe you're carrying your art supplies as well, and then all of a sudden you've got to choose a different size bungee again. There's the LapStacker. You can carry it all nice and easily, really simply. Thanks for joining me on the Bungee versus LapStacker video. If you'd like to know more about the LapStacker and Adaptify, visit adaptify.com. If you've got any more comments or you'd like other videos made, please leave a comment below and give us a thumbs up if you like this video. Thumbs down if you didn't like it. We'd love all feedback. Thanks so much for joining me. I'm Mike from Adaptify.